Hello, Mr. Gazda here. And yes, my silhouette does look really weird on the screen, but today we're gonna do waterfall formation, how a waterfall forms. So, check it out. Let's say we start here with a bit of a hill. These are three different layers of bedrock, green, purple, red is what I'm using to show them. And let's say you now add a river in there. So you have a river flowing over this flat area and then flowing downhill here. Now, let's think about what's happening in the river itself. You have pebbles and rocks the size of my fist or maybe even bigger. They're kind of rolling and skidding along the bottom. They're rubbing against the bedrock itself, causing abrasion, and that's going to be a type of erosion. You have sand moving along the river, also be scratching and wearing away, eroding this bedrock. So give it some time, erosion will occur. And it will look like this. So you can see some has been eroded. The one key thing that I need to point out for a waterfall to form, this particular condition must exist. And it is, the top layer of rock must be more resistant to erosion than the bottom layers. So this will erode slower and these will erode faster. That will lead to a waterfall, as we're gonna see. So give it some more time and more erosion. This will happen. More time passes, now you have what you think of a traditional waterfall here. You'll have a pool of water down here with all the force of the water. It will swirl around, the rocks in there, and sand will really kind of bounce back here, rub up against it, cause more erosion down there. And then you have this. See, a little bit of an overhang is forming. Now there's more of an overhang. Obviously, at some point, this can't just keep sticking out. It will stick out too much and break off, and it will look like this. That happens, a huge chunk of rock will be at the base of the waterfall here. We still have that swirling of rock here, eroding these layers there. Then you have that, another overhang. That layer breaks off. And then this will continue as we see here. And you may notice that the waterfall is moving this way. It's retreating. It's retreating upstream. And that's what waterfalls do. So I'm gonna play this in a bit more sped up to get a good sense of the animation. Okay, so here we have Niagara Falls. It's the Horseshoe Falls. And I'm showing this so you really get a sense of the power and the force of the water going over the falls. It's really amazing. Check it out. Okay, so here, this is Horseshoe Falls, Niagara Falls, sort of overhead view. Here's a boat here for scale. These are cars, so you get a sense of the scale here. And this is continually to erode upstream this way. If you look at this picture here, this is sort of an overhead view of the falls right here, and it shows where the falls were during these years. In 1678, all the way back in 1678, it was here, and 1764, so it's been retreating backwards. We have a human record of this. Hard to get a sense of scale there, but if you look at this, I like this picture because it shows the Horseshoe Falls here, so this is this perspective. We're kind of looking downstream, and so here's the valley here that it's slowly been retreating up this valley over the past few thousand years. Check out this picture, okay? So let's see our perspective here. Now we're sort of downstream looking upstream. Here are the falls that we were just looking at. So this is the Horseshoe Falls of Niagara Falls, and then this is the whole, is the valley here. It kind of shows it pretty clearly, and again, it's been eroding slowly year after year up this valley to, it is currently right here, and it's gonna continue back up that way. And we have a sense that it has eroded, it has moved about 6.8 miles over about the past 12,000 years. You average that out, it ends up being about 3 feet per year is over that time is what Niagara Falls has been retreating up that valley, so that's pretty cool.